Hello, hello. Good afternoon, everyone. How's everyone today? I need more energy than that. How are y'all doing today?
Good!
Good, 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 good. My name is Kyla Williams, and I'm the interim executive director of the Smart Chicago Collaborative, and we, of course, are part of the reason why you're here today. We are so happy. Y'all look good. Look at y'all. Y'all look good. Got your hairs all done and your outfits together. I'm really happy to be here today. The Youth-Led Tech Program is something that I'm super passionate about. It is the thing that I really live for. It drives us a little crazy, certainly, during the summertime, because it takes a lot of work to coordinate all this stuff. But I'm really happy to see all of your faces, and to our parents and our other visitors that are here today. I don't do this work alone. This year, we hired some staff to help a sister out because there's so much to do. So Monica Swope acted as our project manager this year, and Anthony Smith was our project coordinator. They're the ones that found the sites and coordinated the meals, so give them a big round of applause. Certainly, none of this would be possible without my staff. We have some super staff members here from Smart Chicago that, although not directly assigned to this program, continue to support me to make sure everything runs smoothly. If you're part of the Smart Chicago team, can you stand up and give a little wave to the people? Thank you, Jari. Thank you. Apparently, Jari's on the payroll now. Certainly our future. Announcement about Jari. So we've been doing a lot of press and pushing, trying to make sure that people recognize the good work that you did, because let's just be real. I can be very real with you because I do this work every day. There are adults that can't do what you've managed to do in 6 weeks. And so there's lots of people that are interested in our program. We just got word today. Have y'all heard of Black Enterprise Magazine? Yeah, Black Enterprise Magazine is a magazine dedicated to black business and trying to really kind of cultivate business in black and brown communities. We got a call for them today. They're interested in highlighting our program, and Jari is one of the students that they chose his website because they were interested in it. So he's going to be highlighted in upcoming months. And again, just shows you how important our work is. I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge our instructors. Where are my instructors for the North Lawndale area? Stand on up. We owe them all of our love and respect, because from what I heard, y'all is a handful. Y'all got a lot of energy and been doing stuff, and they were able to still manage to get the curriculum taught and get the websites, you know, assisting you with getting your websites built. So we're certainly very thankful for them. And you parents and guardians and other support systems that are in the audience, we know that raising children today in 2016 is a tough, 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 tough job. So we thank you. We're going to give them a round of applause, youth and everybody. Mamas, daddies, grandmamas, aunties, neighbors, etc., for supporting y'all as we do this work. I'm going to share a little bit of a story about me, and then we'll kind of move through our program. So when I was a senior in high school, a counselor, you know, preparing to go to college, a counselor had told me, when I was talking about my dreams, because I said I wanted to be a doctor, I wanted to live internationally, I wanted to speak all these languages, I wanted to travel and, you know, kind of do things that were a little more unorthodox for my peers at the time. And I told him, you know, where should I go? Where should I apply to college to get these things done? And he told me, you know, black girls don't really do what you want to do. So my suggestion to you is to maybe apply for a black school, a black college, or maybe you can go to the community college, because, you know, people that look like you and grow up where you grow up, they don't get to do those types of things, right? Now, growing up in my family, of course, you know, that wasn't gonna fly, because I was very sad for about a week or two, not my normal self, because I felt like all the things that I did, you know, the studying and trying to get good grades and helping out in the community, that none of those things mattered, because in a matter of minutes, this person, this adult person, who I trusted to help guide my future, told me that it didn't matter that I was only supposed to be a certain person and live a certain life and do certain things. So when I told my parents after they noticed that I was a little down, they of course, and parents that are out there, you know, if somebody say something like that to your baby, you know what happens next, right? Indeed. So, we won't talk about that on the camera. But certainly, I wasn't raised that way. I was raised to believe that I could do anything and everything and all things. And even if I tried at something and it didn't quite work out, that there was even victory in having the courage to try and to live my life and design it the way that I wanted it to be lived and how I wanted it to be executed. And I could have as big dreams as I wanted to. There is no limitation on your life. And there are people in this world that because of the way you look and where you grew up and what your name is and who your mama and them is trying to tell you that you have a limit on your life. And I'm here to tell you that life is really limitless. You can be, do, grow, execute anything that you actually want to do. It just takes a little bit of courage. And I know y'all got some courage because y'all came to this program every single day. Ate some of the meals that was a little questionable. We apologize for that. That took some courage. But certainly, there is no limitation on your life. Just you participating in this program is a demonstration that you have the potential to be and do anything that you want to do and be. And you have all of these helpful adults that are here cheering you on. These instructors, they could have been doing anything else this summer. I think some of them wanted to run away a couple of days too, because y'all was kind of doing things. But they chose to spend the summer with you to try to bring you into this technology life and show you a couple different things. So whether you want to be a technologist or a nurse or a musician or fashion designer or anything that is even unorthodox and not even something that you've heard other people say, you have the ability to do that. You just need to believe in yourselves. And if you need some help, some guidance, ask questions. One of the things I told my son when he was going away to college was, you have to ask the right questions. It's important for you to ask the right questions. If you don't know what the right questions are, get with somebody who looks like you doing what you want to do. Ain't no need to hate. If you want what they want, get next to them, figure out how they got there, and then do better. Your job is to not only go to your limit, but to move beyond your limit. Grow, continuously grow. That is your charge today. Y'all hear me? Am I just talking crazy? Am I just talking to myself? You hear me, see, Jaree? I know, that's why you got chosen. I know about you, Jaree. So that's my story, and I just wanted to encourage you to continue along the way. This is just the first step along a lot of steps that you're going to be charged with. So we need you to make better decisions and to continue to push forward, certainly. I think I saw Adam come in here. Are you ready? On the spot. So we have a lot of partners that helped us to get this work done. Certainly Microsoft. Y'all heard of Microsoft, right? Yeah. So when you think of Microsoft, sometimes you think about like the software and maybe some of the hardware. Wait. We having side conversations over here. Didn't we learn this like day two? Mm-hmm. I know. I got you. He gonna tell you in a minute. I appreciate your enthusiasm, young man. What's your name?
John.
John. Mm-hmm. My little brother name is John. He hard-headed too. Anywho, Microsoft is one of our partners again this year for the Youth-Led Tech Program, and Adam is going to come and share a couple of words with you. Give him a big round of applause.
Well, thank you, and thank you for having me. I'm sorry I'm a few minutes late. I was in the wrong area here. Does this not come out? Okay. Well, then let's just see if we can make it go a little lower. Can't do that either. All right. Well, thank you for having me out here today, everybody, and congratulations on what you did. This is pretty amazing. My name is Adam Heckman. I am the Director of Technology and Civic Innovation for Microsoft, which means that I go into the neighborhoods and go into the communities, and I work with community organizations and civic leaders and activists and try to figure out what's the best way to use technology to solve some of the most intractable problems in the city. Now, let me give you a little bit of a history lesson. On June 28th of 1966, it was 50 years ago, 6 weeks ago, I was born in a Southside hospital. About 6 weeks later, 50 years ago from today, does anybody know what happened 50 years ago from today on the southwest side of Chicago?
No.
What? No? Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. marched in Marquette Park, and it became a very famous event. It became a milestone in the Dr. King story. Now, at that time, in the nearby neighborhood, Chicago Lawn, my grandpa was a rabbi at a synagogue called Congregation Lawn Manor. And the synagogue was set up as a safe house. So let me explain to you what a safe house is. A safe house is a place that you set up for someone to go if things get really, really bad. Okay? And it was a place that Dr. King could be swiftly ushered into and held in safety should the situation for him turn catastrophic. And it never turned catastrophic, but it did turn pretty bad. You know, he got hit with some rocks and he faced some terrifying violence, but fortunately he didn't need to retreat to the synagogue. Now tonight, I'm going to honor Dr. King's legacy by returning to that synagogue that housed the congregation that my grandfather led. Here's what's interesting about it. Today, the synagogue is an all-black congregation of Jews. It's African Americans, it's Africans, it's Latinos, and other Jews of color. They're going to celebrate Dr. King's teaching on this, the 50th anniversary of a very special moment in that history. So I'll be celebrating the Jewish Sabbath with my brothers and sisters from this special community. Now, that's tonight. Today, I'm going to celebrate your accomplishments with you. As the people that are sitting in this room and the people who have gone through this program, you're Dr. King's legacy. Now, you're going to have, you went through this great program and you're going to get some great results out of it, but keep in mind that you have a responsibility. You have a responsibility to keep that legacy alive, and you have to do that by continuing your education, by not only taking jobs in the technical community, but by becoming leaders of the tech community. Each one of you needs to, I'm going to challenge you, each one of you needs to teach and mentor 10 other people who were like you when you first started with the youth-led tech project. You need to be the ones, you need to be the leaders that start a new business or lead innovation in an existing business or inspire that next generation that comes after you. Now, you've been through a very challenging and I would say a very rewarding program through youth-led tech. So you've done some amazing projects, you've made some rewarding relationships, you've learned a tremendous amount in a very short period of time. So you should be congratulated. If my grandfather were here today, and he were the one standing here, what he would say to you is Mazel Tov V'Yasher Koach, which means congratulations and may you go from strength to strength. The strength of what you got out of that youth-led tech program to the strength of making other people great. So thank you for giving me a few minutes to talk with you, and again, congratulations.
Chicago. shot last week are now up there, so you may see yourself and help us to promote the show. Go ahead and spread it around your own personal networks. I want to take this opportunity to highlight our partners in the facilities, because again, we had to have y'all someplace, and people graciously agreed to work with us so that we could house you in safe places and have opportunities to, you know, not only learn our curriculum but participate in some recreation and stuff. So we want to give some love to ABC Polk Brothers CYC. I think I saw Miss Roberta walk in. Hey, Miss Roberta. Of course, the Firehouse Community Arts Center with Pastor Field. Did he just do that? And certainly the Better Boys Foundation, BBF. Off in the future, right, and plenty of being gay. So it's time for the certificates of completion and the awarding of the laptops. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Can I have the staff for CYC up here, please? They're going to give some remarks, and then we'll go ahead and get things going.
Yes, you do. How y'all feel?
Good.
Y'all ready?
Yep.
So I just want to say something very briefly. I'm getting sick. Very briefly, I am not gonna cry. As the weeks have wrapped up, many of you guys have expressed that you're gonna miss us. We've said the same thing. I know you're gonna miss me, Trayshawn. It's all right. We've said the same thing, and it is absolutely true. This has been a really rewarding experience for me as a parent. At one point in time, a single parent raising boys, knowing how hard it can be to keep them involved and engaged, even with all of the best of everything, being able to share from my experiences, from the knowledge that I've learned, being able to see you guys take it in and try to enjoy it as well as grow it into something has really been awesome. And so I just want to thank all of you guys for spending the time with me, and Kyla, Anthony, and Monica for having me on board this summer. Thank you.
How y'all doing? I lost track of what I was gonna say. But yeah, this is my first time being as a teacher for Smart Chicago. I see y'all as my little brothers and sisters. Y'all crazy. Y'all taught me a lot, how to be patient with y'all. Even when I wanted to say, get joy. I didn't say that. Put that in camera. But yeah, I have learned a lot for y'all. I'm proud of y'all. Yeah, I'm funny. You see they laughing. But yeah, I just want to say, have fun or something.
Hello, everybody. I just wanted to say that I would truly miss all of you. This has been a growing experience, a life-changing experience for me. I feel like I wasn't able to just teach you all, I was able to learn from you all as well. And that is nothing that I can take back. So I give you all the best of luck in your future endeavors, and enjoy the rest of your summer.
Yeah.
No, I had an opportunity to actually work with everyone in this program, and I'm just so grateful for the experience. We had a lot of good days and some bad days, but I'm just grateful for the experience overall. I want to encourage all of you to really take advantage of the things things that you learn, because there's not a lot of people ages 12 and 13 and 14 and 15 who have people to give them an opportunity to start a business and build your business and build websites. So I want to encourage you and the parents to check in with them monthly to make sure that they're taking advantage of the opportunity that they have here. Because a lot of people don't get that opportunity. So grateful for the experience. Good luck to all of you. I'm going to be Googling y'all names in 10 years to see what's going on with y'all. And who's successful. Marley, definitely Googling your name.
All right, so all of my CYC babies start with Harlem. They go around and just line up for us so we can call your names, okay?
It's all right, we change the order. We do that sometimes. Come on, come on. Go ahead.
So we're going to follow. Let's follow. Erica.
Ready.
So what do you guys do?
Well, actually, if you don't want to say that name.
All right.
And while we do her
life, Manny Hodges. Harlan Williams. Jason Evans.
Don't take the picture. Erica Jones.
Alex Valtierra. Trayshawn Banks. Amani Bryant. Ashanti Bryant. Kariyan Sanders. Sonya Hodges. Michaela Washington. Congratulations, guys.
So in addition to the youth being able to earn the laptops, because we're not giving away laptops, I want us to get out of the practice of saying that you got a laptop. We want you to say you earned a laptop. You did 160 learning hours around technology, workforce development, communication skills, interpersonal skill building, better relationship building. These three right here, we're going to have to get them back in the program next week. So a note to point to, Kanardro, the gentleman that taught this year at CYC, was a student last year. And we hired him to be an instructor this year. So all of you have the opportunity next year when we have the program to apply to be instructors and join our staff. So, he said, do we get some money? That's a job, this is a job. Kanardro makes money. Kanardro, where you at? You make money. So we like like that, because that shows that he learned something and then was inspired enough to come back and give as well in the community. Our next site that we're bringing up is this site, I believe, the Firehouse Community Arts Center instructors. Give it up for them as they come.
All right, hello everybody. Hope everyone's doing well. I'll just say some words. Thank you, love. I might cry too, it's okay. I feel very honored to be here, very honored that I've taught all of you this summer. Just seeing you guys kind of grow throughout the last 6 weeks has been such a pleasure. I've been working with youth for the last couple of years, so I will keep you guys in my heart forever and always. And good luck with whatever you do in your future. You are all very special in your own individual ways. So believe in that, continue with all of your goals, and you will get there with a little bit of hard work, but you will definitely get there. All right, good luck.
Yes, I am your teacher. My name is April Thomas, and I am one of the instructors here at the Firehouse location. And to my youth, my 10 children that I have gained, y'all embarrassing me now. I just want to say to you, it has been an honor to serve. That's what I did. I served each and every one of you, even though I was mentoring and playing parent, playing disciplinarian and all that, that my love is genuine for each and every one of you, to Marlique, Aaliyah, Jahida, to Tejon, Lafayette, Tejon, Lafayette, Jari, Renee, Kalia, Mahalia, and Miss Aaliyah Moore. I appreciate all of you. Y'all talking too much. Y'all gonna make me show how I really act in the firehouse. Shh, yay. I appreciate all of you. Just remember that you all can do any and everything that you can do, that you put your mind into. Remember to ask for help. There's no stupid questions. And you all should have my number. If you still need me, I'm just a phone call away. And I'm looking forward to the success in your lives. All right?
All right.
All right.
Hi. So I'm John Wagonmaker. I'm another instructor. So I guess I'll say some stuff. So I know I had kind of a rough start. A few of you guys thought I was from the suburbs, just not true. I'm three blocks down the street. So, you know, we had a lot of good days, we had some bad days. I know the day I blocked YouTube, but it was really a good time teaching all of you guys. We had some good times, some good conversations, and learning opportunities, and exploring the wonderful world that is technology. So, hope you guys go out to the world and do good things, and hope you learn something from this program, and I helped out with that.
I'm gonna give the props to the CYC students. They won in the kickball tournament on yesterday. But still and yet, y'all had to have 12 to my 5. That's all I'm gonna say.
Y'all earned it. Marlique Caston. Love, anything?
No, I'm good.
Aaliyah Bennett.
Jahijah Garrison. T-John, TJ, because I can never give his name right. T-John Price. Lafayette Hodges. AKA John. All-star player, Jaree Clark.
Say your name.
Mr. Techie himself, Renee Valtierra. To my personal baby, Kalia Solid.
Thank you.
Mahalia Holden. Last but not least, my inspiration, Miss Aaliyah Moore.
Let's give him a big round of applause. April's like the sergeant of arms of UFLA Tech, boy. She just fixed everybody. She makes me do stuff. I'm like, okay, what am I doing? Jeez. So our next group, this is a special group. So, you know, we had the different sites separated by age, and BBF, the Better Boys Foundation, was for the older kids. And we were competing against kids trying to get jobs and other things that were going on. So we started out with a group of 12, supposedly, but actually only ended up with one superstar student who stayed with us the entire time. And I want the BBF staff to come on up and give some remarks about that and honor this young man. Come on up, BBF staff.
Hi, everybody. Terry, this is all about you. My name is Phyllis West, and I had the pleasure of working with many of you this summer, but the bulk of my time was spent with Terry. Terry, thank you for being such an outstanding student. You are brilliant. You are very intentional. You're thoughtful. You have a social consciousness. But most of all, you have a gift. And you know technology with the back of your hand. So I just want to congratulate you and say how proud I am of you. And I know that you're going to be extremely successful. Thank you, Terry.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Julius. Also, instructor BBF. Terry, man, when you came in, like you blew me away, man. Like you knew just about as much as I knew when it came to technology. I love that you stuck with it with your website. I love that you came up with two websites instead of the one. And I want you to keep going. Like, I know you do great things with your technology. So I want you to keep up with your coding. I want you to keep up with school. I want you to be the most successful black man that I know. And I'm gonna make sure that you're successful because I'm gonna keep up on you all the time. I'm gonna call you school. I'm gonna make sure your grades are up to score. I'm gonna make sure you get into college because I'm not gonna let you fall through the cracks, man.
Hello, I'm Jakara. I was also an instructor at VBF, and I also had the pleasure of meeting all of you. With Terry, I learned so much about myself and about working with someone so close in age with me. it was wonderful to see you step out of your shell. Because that first day, you were like off to yourself, playing on your tablet, and you just seemed like you didn't want to be a part of the group. But over the time, you opened up, you made me go back to where I was and had to study something so I could help you. For the rest of you, sometimes I know when you saw me, I wasn't talking, I was watching, and I see how great all of you are. I see the potential in each and every one of you, and I want you to continue to be great. And I will, you can come up this way too. And I will award this certificate and this laptop to Terry.
It takes a lot of courage to stand solo sometimes, you know what I mean? And he's standing in that program by himself, and he learned a lot. One of the other things that we like to highlight in our program is that it's co-created. So it's not just youth learning things, it's adults learning things as well, so that when we all walk away from this experience, we are certainly all better for it. I would like to just give one last thank you to our partners, Get in Chicago, who's the funder of the program. Let's give them a round of applause. Microsoft, who provided us some assistance with the purchasing of the technology, the laptops. And CRT Labs that assisted us with purchasing the book bags and some other items for them. So for parents, if you attended the demo day and you are here today at graduation, we do have a little bit of an incentive to assist you as you move through your journey. To our youth, all of your websites are going to be on our website, the Smart Chicago website, on Monday. So use that to brag about yourselves a little bit and talk to other people about the work that you did. Again, thank you for participating in the program. We are so very proud of you. And we have some cupcakes and beverages for everybody to participate in. Thank you so much again.